Okay.
So good morning, students. In this class, we'll be continuing with the Mendelian genetics. In the previous class, we have completed about the various conditions of genes. That is, the homozygous condition, heterozygous condition, and we have discussed about the monohybrid cross and its laws according to the Mendel. In this class, we'll be dealing with the further topics in your unit 2. That is nothing but the first topic we are going to deal here is called as test cross. So what do you mean by test cross? Test cross is a cross made between F1 hybrid and the recessive parent. So let's take an example. So capital R is crossed with that of small r and small r. This is responsible for round character and this one is responsible for your wrinkled character. So we have taken the example in a pea plant. In a pea plant we have taken the example here. So in this, capital R gene is responsible for the round character and the wrinkled character by the small r and small r. So when we have a F1 hybrid, when they both cross, we get the product like capital R, small r. This is what the F1 hybrid. This is what the F1 hybrid after the fusing of these two. This is the F1 hybrid. So how do you conduct test cross? Test cross is a cross made between F1 hybrid and the recessive parent. What do you mean by F1 hybrid test cross? Yes, a cross made between F1 hybrid and the recessive parent is called as what? Test cross. So it is like capital R smaller, first with that of smaller, smaller. So we'll get the frequency like capital R smaller. Here smaller will be there, capital R smaller. Capital R smaller and smaller, smaller. This is the resultant of your F test cross. So what do you mean by test cross? A cross made between the F1 hybrid with that of a recessive parent is called as your test cross. This is the next topic. So when we come to the next thing called as dihybrid test cross. Dihybrid test cross. It is also simple. So dihybrid test cross is nothing but okay, before dihybrid test cross, we will go for dihybrid cross. So, dihybrid cross is a cross made between parents with two contrasting characters. So, here capital R is again what? Roundness of a seed and capital T is the tallness. So, we are taking here two characters. We are taking two characters. Here, we are taking again two characters which are just related to each other. So here it is round, here it is wrinkled, here it is tall, here it is dwarf. So a cross made between two parents with having two contrasting characters. In the monohybrid cross we are having one character, that is only capital R or only capital T. But in a dihybrid cross we are having two characters. At a time we are considering two characters. This is what we called as a dihybrid cross. Again, when you cross this one, you will get a F1 hybrid. So, whatever the resultant you will get here as your F1 hybrid, that will be crossed with that of the recessive parent here. So, this is the recessive parent. As I told you in my previous video, what do you mean by recessive condition? So, this is dominant, this is recessive. Both are having the opposite characters. If it is round, it is wrinkled. If it is tall, it is dwarf. This is called as a recessive parent. So, when a cross is made between F1 hybrid with that of the recessive parent, that can be called as test cross normally. But if you are doing it in a dihybrid condition, you can call that as dihybrid test cross. So, there is no difference between a monohybrid test cross and a dihybrid test cross. Just in monohybrid cross, you will be having only one character, but in a dihybrid test cross, you will be having two characters at a time. This is what you mean by a dihybrid test cross. Okay, so the next topic.
Okay.
Next topic is back cross. So what do you mean by back cross? Back cross is nothing but similar to that of your test cross. So let's take an example. AA is crossed with small a, small a. This is your genes. When cross cross to get capital A, small a as your F1 hybrid. This will be your F1 hybrid here. If the product, that is F1 hybrid, is crossed with either of the parents. Should you get the point? Here, in case of a test cross, you should cross with only with that of the recessive parent. But in case of a back cross, you can cross the F1 hybrid with any of the parents. That kind of cross is called as a back cross. That kind of cross is called as back cross. Here, see, remember again, F1 hybrid can be crossed with either of the parents, both a recessive parent as well as a dominant parent, to get another hybrid, that is your F2 hybrid. So F2 hybrid is equal to capital A small a into small a, or capital A small a crossed with capital A. As I told, both the possibilities you can check with a dominant parent or a recessive parent to get your F1 hybrid. So after this topic, we have a question, why there is a need for a test cross or a back cross. So when you are conducting a test cross or a back cross, you will get various genotypes. ಈಗೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಏನ್ ಬರುತ್ತಪ್ಪ, ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಟು ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಆರ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಆರ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದೇ ಒಂದು ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಆರ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ವಿತ್ ರೆಸೆಸಿವ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್, ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಏನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡಿ, ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಆರ್ ಬೇರೆ ಬಂತ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದೇ ಬಂದಿದ್ದು, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಬಂದಿದೆ, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಏನಪ್ಪ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಗೆಟ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಜಿನೋಟೈಪ್ಸ್, ಇನ್ನ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ಜಿನೋಟೈಪ್ ನಮಗೆ ಆ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗಬಹುದು. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್ ವೈ ಎ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಡನ್, ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಟು ಅನಲೈಸ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಜಿನೋಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬೋತ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್.